town mouse and country mouse. The town mouse is from the city and lives in an urban community. The country mouse is from the farm and lives in a rural community. They go to visit each other and learn an important lesson. Can you figure out what it is?
Once upon a time, there was a little gray mouse who lived in a very big house in town.
I need a vacation. I will go visit my cousin in the country.
At last, he reached his cousin's home in a wheat field.
Come in, come in. I'm so pleased to see you. You're just in time to have supper with me.
I've had a long walk, and I'm feeling very tired and hungry.
Town Mouse looked at the food that Country Mouse had spread out.
That's not very much food. Is that all you have to eat?
You can have a slice of apple. And we can share these and the wheat. When we have finished our supper, I'll make a bed for you.
Town Mouse tossed and turned on the bed of straw that Country Mouse had made for them.
Oh, how I wish that I was back at the big house in my own bed of warm, soft, worn feathers. This bed is so hard, I cannot sleep. It's so quiet here, too.
Just then, an owl zooped down over the wheat field.
Toot toot!
What's that noise? It's so scary. I don't like this place at all.
The next morning, Country Mouse took Town Mouse out for a walk.
Let me show you around that wheat field. There's lots to see.
No sooner they had begun their walk when a large weasel rushed by.
What's that? What's that?
Quick, hide, it's a weasel. They eat mice.
I don't like it here in the country. There are strange noises and scary animals. Why don't you come and stay with me? You will have plenty to eat and a soft feather bed to sleep on.
Yes, I would like that. I will come with you to the town.
It was getting dark as Town Mouse and Country Mouse reached the town.
It's so busy here and there's so much noises and so many bright lights.
Don't be scared. We're here now. This is my home. Follow me down this hallway, then we'll squeeze under the door and go into the kitchen.
Country Mouse scuttled quickly along behind Town Mouse.
I can smell something good to eat. I feel much better already.
Climb up here onto the table, cousin. Look at all this food!
I've never seen so much food before. This cheese is so tasty.
Just then, the kitchen door opened and in came the cook with a crash and a bang.
Quick! Hide! The cook will see you!
Where do I hide? I know, I can get behind this jug.
Mice, I have been eating the cheese. I am going to have to set the trap to catch.
She's gone. I'm so scared. I have to find Town Mouse. Where is he? Oh no, there's an enormous cat by the fire. I hope it doesn't wake up. Where is Town Mouse?
Country Mouse, I'm over here. Come on, quick, run.
Country Mouse raced down the leg of the table and across the kitchen floor to the hole in the wall.
I'm so glad to find you.
Don't worry, we can have some more food tomorrow. There's always plenty left over for us to eat. Come along. You can have my soft feather bed.
I can't sleep here in this big house. There are lots of loud noises and so many chirping feet.
Meow. I feel nice again. Meow.
That cat has been scratching at the hole in this wall all night. I'm really scared of it. I'm going home in the morning. I don't like it.
The next morning, Town Mouse was ready to show Country Mouse in the town.
Come on, cousin. There's so much to see here in the town. I want to show you around.
No, thank you. The town is no place for me. And the country is no place for you. I'm the Country Mouse, and you are a town.
And Country Mouse waved goodbye to his cousin and ran off down the road back to his home in the country.
We saved the life.